The sun is shining. It's quite late. I'm in a super ghetto garage and it's time to do a walk around the 600cc go-kart, which is in a testing phase again now. So, what it is? Pretty much it's a I don't know how old, but I was, let's say, 10-year-old rental go-kart chassis. Why rental go-kart chassis? Because it uses a lot thicker steel and it's heavier and it's more robust. It doesn't flex a lot at all, and so that's why I thought maybe that's a good idea to use that one, because this engine does produce 120 horsepower. Wow. Or thereabouts. So yeah, a rental go-kart frame, a bit modified, a bit strengthened, all that nonsense. A 2000 Honda CBR 600 engine. CBR 600 F4 engine, the carbureted one, which is also rocking a Ignitech, or however you say, Spark F4 ignition unit, which allows me to just plug it into the laptop and just do all sorts of trickery with ignition and the timing and all that good stuff. And yeah, a Yoshimura muffler with a very short header, 4:1. Originally it has 4:2:1, but this is 4:1, and of course it does fuck with the timing and the overlap and all that stuff, but I'm fighting with it, so it should be fine. Yeah, but otherwise the engine is fully stock, except the ignition unit and the main jets and slow jets are changed. Still in the process of doing that, waiting for my jet kits. But then, yeah, so that's the engine. The brake system. The front brakes on this car are from a CRG. They are CRG, which is, I think, the standard pro car, pro class go-kart manufacturer thingy. Короче, it's just ventilated twin discs in front. And so we enter the three disc CRG in front and custom brakes in the rear, which is a ventilated and drilled brake rotor. And ghetto modified CBR 600 4 piston front caliper, which is the Nissan brand. Yeah, and then I just go in the front, connected here, again CRG, master cylinder, and then it's, what name is it? Whatever that is. Master cylinder connected together to a splitter or adjuster, and they just go to the pedal. Yeah, and they work fine actually. This go-kart stops. I'm actually surprised how good it stops. It stops really fast. First of all, probably because of the weight, added weight, so the traction is better on the tires, and yeah, full slotted and ventilated brakes everywhere. Then the shifter mechanism. Oh, this is ghetto, man. So it's just a 20 mil or 22 mil. No, it's actually 25 mil pipe, which is ghetto bent, and rocking a, yeah, the standard clutch lever, ghetto bent. Then it goes to this thing, this piece. Actually it deserves like a Nobel Prize or something. It's pretty much three steel plates welded together, square steel plates welded together, then a hole machined to fit three bearings, which hold this thing, and then these are like locking screws. It's total ghetto, but it works. And then there's a welded another piece of metal that is adjustable, so you can adjust the lever arm length for the shifter. Yeah, so that's the front ghetto-ish thing. And then the rear, we have an aluminium piece going to the shifter, and then it's bolted on a steel piece, which then goes to the lever arm again. And yeah, that's how it works. So something like that. Then next thing, the chain mechanism thingy, chain adjusted tension, whatever. So we are using a 525 chain with I think 16 gears here, and fuck, I don't remember how many gears here, and a, not tensioner, but a idler we're here with three brains in the middle in it, machine to fit three brains. So this is an island that changed so it doesn't like wobble a lot because it will be hitting the engine block. You can see it's machined there. And then yeah, we're using two machined steel rods with uniballs in the end to lift up the rear of the engine. And when I'm lifting the rear of the engine, I'm of course tightening the chain. We did have different designs before, but this seems to be the best one and works really good actually. Of course, we are rocking the standard three bearings with a double, I think these are the widest hubs they had, the longest hubs with like double locking nuts and all that good stuff. Then the cooling system, we're using a action. Oh, if you can guess what is this, like from what this thing is, this radiator thingy, where does it come from? You get extra internet points if you can guess in the comments. And then yeah, it just goes to some splitters. Really, really, really shitty design here because we were rushing to the festival. Don't judge me, it's fine. And then it just goes straight there in the rat's nest. This cooling system I think has 17 or 18 points of failure, but none of them actually have failed yet, so that is to come. Yeah, and again, this is the switchboard. This is the switchboard. You have the main switch, you have the starter switch, you have the dropper stopper, which switches on the electric stuff. And then you have one that is not connected to anything yet. And you have the AC, which is the fan, of course. And powering everything, or showing everything, all the monitoring is done by Stage 6 Digital Dash, which works kind of cool. It shows the temperature, it shows the speed, it shows the RPMs and all that good stuff. So that has worked out quite nicely. And I think that's pretty much it. We can try to start it up, let it warm up, and then I will let you hear it, guys. So this amazing starting sequence, all the lights on, all the good stuff, and of course it has lights that warn you when you are way too over the temperature, or the ship light also, all that good stuff. Yep, gonna let it warm up and then show you how it sounds. I think it's fine to rev it up now. And it's bit some play because it's, the carburetors are quite rich now. It was done on a purpose for the show that we went to. Because now it's bit some mad flames, man. So, this is the 600cc go-kart, and there are some videos of me running it on the channel, so if you want to see them, feel free. GSP